All right, game three. This is the rubber match. Nobody wants to be 0-2. This is a very good hand, though. For sure. I mean, Shackles, the classic mono blue versus mono white matchup. Shackles is a key card. And we've got some other things to do in the early game this time around, so I like our chances. I'm trying to keep my heart rate down, not get too excited and F6 through our first turn. All right, Card Shark Willy shows up to play. Serum Visions. We can use lands, so that's the main thing to look for here. I think that I will maybe like Daze a lot, actually. It's a pretty tough call. Both these cards are pretty good. The game plan is gonna be to Condescend or Coral Helm turn two. We have got a lot of options. I think Daze is maybe. I feel like I like Daze. We could play Shackles turn three and have Daze up. And then Jace is a good one too. I know that we're like. None of these are the fourth land, so that's kind of iffy, but. We can cast everything we have with three, and then once we get to four, Jace would be a nice thing to have. It's pretty good against a weenie deck, the plus ability, or the minus ability, really. Elite Vanguard. So we could play Coral Helm on this next turn, or we could play Condescend. It's a pretty tough call either way, because the Coral Helm would just trade, and there's a chance the Condescend gets nothing. But I decided on Condescend because, I don't know, maybe that was wrong. Eight and a half tails. We'll happily Condescend that. And then we can play Vidalkin Shackles on this next turn with Daze back up. My game plan is not wait till five mana with this, just get it out as soon as possible. And we have a fourth land. And a Jace, and I believe I put them both on top. I tried to. I'm about 50% for actually getting there on those, so can't guarantee it. I feel like we have time to play Vendilion Click to take an enchantment or enchantment kill out of the opponent's hand. I feel like that's really probably a game-winning play and worth doing, so I'm going to wait on the shackles, even after just saying that I want to get it down as soon as possible. Throwing the Vendilion Click down mid-combat, not really looking to race, more just stabilize. We can trade if we need to trade or not trade if we don't need to trade. Day of Judgment is fine. Banisher Priest. Hallowed, what does this do? When it dies, put X11 spirits. We're X the number of creature cards in your graveyard. So that's kind of a combo. I would be happy to leave all of these because none of them deal with shackles, but the Spirit Keeper would be the scariest thing because the opponent can dave. Even if we take it with shackles, the opponent can Day of Judgment it, and it can do some things. But actually, let's just daze it this turn. Why don't we say keep all of those and take the hit for two? No, because of the Banisher Priest. Let's trade. Keep those. I already didn't take a print screen, but it was Banisher Priest, that three drop, and a Day of Judgment. Gonna daze this three drop. And oh, the opponent is not playing anything. That's even better because I guess they're are they playing around Daze? I don't think any of those things had flash. Reel the top three. Almost certainly taking the pile with more cards. Yeah, I will take the pile with more cards. Let's take the pile with more cards. Although, I mean, a Moloku would be nice. We can definitely put the fifth land to use, though. shackles this thing. And we still have the days, which the opponent seemed to play around, but not. I don't know, they just didn't want to expose that card. Or did I get rid of it? I'm starting to doubt reality. Pretty sure I said keep. Frost Titan. I'm going to play Coral Helm and keep up Essence Scatter for that Banisher Priest that we know about. This is one of the reasons why I didn't want to play Coral Helm, because it kind of telegraphs that we have stuff, but whatever, it's a body is a body. Counter that. F6. Probably just take the pile with more cards, unless it's two lands, because we already have six lands at this point. That's interesting. Because Jason Land, I would take the compulsive over Jason Land, I guess. Check this out. What does it take to level? Oh, wow, the opponent gave us compulsive and land. I mean, Jace is legendary, so we can't use this one. One, two, three, four. I'm just gonna level this. Force the opponent to play Day of Judgment. We don't necessarily need to play Compulsive Research right away, and holding Shackles for longer allows us to play it as a surprise. I still don't understand why the opponent didn't play that 3-2. But at this point, it seems like it's going to be pretty tough to lose. Card Shark Willy's upkeep. I'm going to F6 because I have no plays. We've got the Frost Titan to tap down whatever threat comes out. But we only want to commit one thing to Day of Judgment. So we can... Yeah, I'm totally baffled, like, why the opponent wouldn't... I don't know. I'm not going to try to figure it out. Attack with the Coral Helm, leaving up Remove Soul, Snapcaster. Need to make sure we uptick this Jace, which has been doing work. It's no Jace the Mind Sculptor, but it's still a good one. Okay, I'm just gonna counter this. It's annoying. It's gonna leave guys behind after Day of Judgment, which was maybe the opponent's play, is play this then Day of Judgment and get 4/1/1s, which is pretty easily beatable, especially with Jace, but I'm still gonna counter it. And at this point, we're taking the opponent to Scoop Town. Population U. We're not even needing the Shackles or even our trusty Old Man of the Sea. Did I miss a land? Oh yeah, I did miss a land drop because of Days. Or I had to pick one up, rather. Alright, opponent has one card left. It's going to have to be a crazy one. Balance. We still get to keep a Planeswalker through Balance, though. Banishing Light to Jace and then Balance. Not in the cube. All right. Headed to match 3. Sweet.